Let me quickly rope in Dr. Sanjay Arora of Suburban Diagnostics from Mumbai. Dr. Arora, welcome back to the telecast. We've had a 3-day gap between us, sir. Things now shaping up where you are in terms of the testing. Have you guys begun? Are you already
out? Yes, probably 5 weeks since we got the approval. And, the demand is much greater than the supply, unfortunately. We have a lot more requests, but we are challenged with supply of kits. Initially, there were two companies approved by ICMR. They've added two more companies to that list. But three of these four companies are international, and we're not able to get reports from those companies as of now. And the Indian company is finding it difficult to ramp up their production capabilities to meet the demand. So currently, there's a huge backlog of tests, and
Is it taking a couple of days, 3 days? I mean, how many are you being able roughly to do? You don't have to give exact figures. How many can you do in a day?
So our capability is, close to 600-700 a day, but we are not getting those many kits. We are getting maybe 200-300 tests in a week, and we are having to manage and get more. So I think everybody is trying that, the government will allow the kits that have been approved to be imported and fast-tracked. There are German companies like Altona, which comments, if we can get those kits imported and fast-tracked,
it's logical, and the faster, the more we can do, the faster we can do. Okay. The next logical question, sir, is we were discussing this a few days ago, and now I understand a national repository on this is being made, so there is some progress. It might not be the perfect progress, but when it comes to getting your PPE sorted out. Now, from what I heard in the conference today, even the cloth to make the protective gear was not manufactured in India. And now some backup options are being cleared. I don't know if they've already been cleared. It's not exploded yet. So we are not in the same situation as Italy or the US yet. So we don't have tens of thousands of patients right now. But even in the current situation, how uncomfortable are we, sir?
No, absolutely. I think that's a very good point you have raised. Any collection without PPEs, currently we have one vendor in the entire, which includes, the headgear, the gown, the goggles, the mask, the shoe cuffs, gloves, everything. But today what we have to do is we have to pick it up piecemeal from different vendors and then assemble it like an assembly line ourselves. So our procurement team has to go hunting for different parts and then bring it all together. So we need support both in terms of getting PPEs as well as in testing kits, because both go hand in hand.
Okay. At this point of time, sir, so the references for testing are coming. There are other options. So there are now, I think, 40 labs such as yours across the country. Every day, a few more are being added, which have the capacity and are being certified by the ICMR. You were one of the first. And there are some, of course, government-run labs also operating. Now, we were supposed to have had 3 lakh testing kits at the get-go a few weeks ago. We've only done 38,000. There should be some in the bank. It's about, I think, spreading them around as more and more labs get added and more of these tests are made. Is the movement, sir, happening of the goods that you require to get these testing kits up and around? I mean, are you getting a shipment per week, shipment every few days?
So we're getting shipment every few days, but not enough that we need. I mean, I would need at least 500 to 700 tests, if not more, every day. We are getting 200 to 300 tests every 3-4 days.
Okay.
So there's a huge gap between what we need and what is actually being available.
So you need 4x, roughly 4x right now to ramp up to the scale of what the demand. And I'm presuming this is not walk-in people. These are people who are being referred to by doctors.
Absolutely. I was just going to come to that. These are only those what we call as, those cases which are filtered due to doctor's prescriptions, which is called as suspect cases. We have not gone into the mode of screening the way it happened, say, in South Korea, where they screened a lot of people. They picked up those cases that were even asymptomatic so that they could self-quarantine and they were able to contain the virus. We are far, far away from that.
Okay, I understand confidentiality terms. You can't share details, sir. But are you worried by the number of positives that you guys are recording, or is it not been crazily high?
So, honestly, when we started, of course, maybe the database was very small and we found higher percentage, but as the days have progressed, I'm happy to share that the positivity rate actually has come down.
Okay, so for every test conducted, it's not 100% percent positive. So everybody coming your way is not positive.
It's not close to that at all.
Okay, all right. Appreciate your thoughts, sir, and putting them up very logically and calmly onto the national domain.
For more such videos, subscribe to the Newsx YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.